Remember, in a paper-shared model, a miner is not incentivized to give their mining pool any valid blocks. There's no actual reward to the individual for finding a share that gives the pool a block. Is there a way that we can exploit this incentive misalignment? Turns out there is. You might have started to predict the attack by now. If we get paid for finding near valid shares, why not just get paid for work without submitting invalid blocks? And this is known as pool cannibalization. You may recognize the person in this image on the right side of the slide. This is Hannibal Lecter, fictitious cannibal from the TV show Hannibal. Just like Hannibal is a person that consumes other people, pools can consume parts of other pools through pool cannibalization. The way we consume other pools is that if we have a decent amount of mining power, we can distribute some of our power into other paper share scheme. But for these pools, we don't actually submit valid blocks. This way, we can get paid by those other pools without increasing their revenue. With pool cannibalization, we increase own personal profit at the detriment of other pools. The advantage of this attack is that it's very hard to detect in small amounts. And let's go ahead and show why this is the case through some calculations. Let's first establish some assumptions. Let's say that we have 30 hashes per second of power in your pool, and the total network has 100 hashes per second. Easily, we see that we have 30% of the network hash rate. On top of that, there is a current block reward of 1 Bitcoin per block. These numbers are, for simplicity's sake, to set up the stage for the pool cannibalization analysis and not at all representative of the real-world conditions. With basis statistics, we can calculate an expectation of profit per block. This is the average profit made per block, which is not to be confused with the profit per individual block. If we have a 30% of the network hash rate, this means that we're also expected to get 30% of blocks in the longest chain. By implication, we're also expecting to earn 30% of total mining rewards on average, which is 0.3 bitcoins per block. Now that we established a scenario, let's consider something. We buy a bit of hardware, currently worth 1% of the total network hash rate, and let's consider what we can do with this extra mining power. The standard simple thing to do with this extra mining power is to add it to your own resources. This means that we have 31 hashes per second, and the total network now has 101 hashes per second. If we do a calculation, we now have 30.69% of the total hash rate, and this means that our increase in profit is 0.0069 bitcoins from our actual hardware. But how can we leverage our previous knowledge about paper share scheme? Well, by doing something mean but profitable, which is distributing our one unit of mining power among all the other pools, the other 70% of the network hash power. However, we make sure to not add to their revenue. We withhold any valid blocks while submitting all other shares. The result is that the pools pay out to us because we're still submitting shares, but does not actually gain any benefit from our hash power since we do not submit valid blocks. And what that looks like in this particular scenario is as this. So the rest of the pools are 70 parts honest and one part dishonest. By honest, we mean mining and submitting valid blocks. And dishonest is obeying this intent and withholding valid blocks, and that's what we're doing. What this means is that the effective hash rate of the other pools has not changed. It's still 70%. However, the mining pools are still paying out to us. This means that our expected value of mining with this 1% of hash power ends up being 0.0098 bitcoins. And now you would notice a scary conclusion, which is dishonesty is more profitable than honesty. We've just shown that it's more profitable to cannibalize pools than to mine directly through our own pool. This is a scary deduction that we just made, but it doesn't stop here. If it's more profitable for any pool to do this, then what does that look like across the network? Will pools all start cannibalizing each other? Is everyone going to start being dishonest for profit? Are pools going to wage war on each other through this attack?